Hello friends, welcome to Insight Learners. So in this video we shall learn the sort command in detail. So we shall learn what actually is the sort command and what are the importance of sort command and when to use sort command, as well as we shall learn the various commands as well as examples with the help of a sort command. So before that, do subscribe our channel and like the video. So first we shall open the git bash terminal. So before using the examples how to use the sort command, so first we shall learn a bit about the sort command. So a sort command, as the name indicates, it is used to sort a file and it arranges the contents or the records in a particular order. So whatever the user gives an input to a file, so it is being sorted in particular order, so therefore it is referred as a sort command. And by default, the sort command, it sorts the file assuming the contents are ASCII characters. And next thing is that so you can also use the sort command in order to sort the numbers numerically, and you can also use it to sort alphabets. So first we shall see the importance of sort command. So the sort command, it sorts the contents of a file line by line. So whatever you give input to a file, so it is being sorted line by line in particular order. So the next thing is that the sort command, it is also used to sort alphabetically, and you can also sort it in reverse order. So the main importance of sort command is that you can sort the alphabets in a particular order, then you can sort it in reverse order. So we shall learn how to sort it in reverse order with the help of various sort options. And next thing is that you can also use a sort command in order to sort the numbers based on ascending order as well as descending, that is either in particular order or in reverse order. And also you can also use a sort command in order to sort the month, like January, February. So based on the months that occurs, so it is being sorted in that order. Suppose if you give the months in random, so it sorts in the particular order. So that is the importance of sort command. And the main thing is that the sort command, it also helps, it is also used to remove the duplicates. So suppose there exist duplicates in an input file, so with the help of a sort command, you can easily remove the duplicates. So the next thing is that, so whenever you give an input to a file, the sort command, it assumes it as a sort key, and then it will sort the contents in a particular order. And suppose if there exists a blank space, so the blank space, by default, it is considered as a field, default field separator. So now quickly we shall learn the usage of sort command with the help of examples. So first of all, in order to sort the contents, we need to create a file. So in previous video, I have shown you how to create a echo command with the help of a echo command, how easily we can create a file. So now we shall see how to with the help of a cat command, how we can easily create a file. So that is cat followed by the unidirectional symbol, then followed by the name of the file. So I shall give the name of the file as the food1.txt. So I shall create a text file which includes the name of the food. So with the help of a cat command followed by the unidirectional symbol followed by the name of the file, I shall give it as food1.txt. So it's a text file, and then enter. So now directly we shall enter the food names. So I shall give the name of the food like dosa, idli, then we shall give noodles, then gobi, then pani puri, then again you can give any number of any names. So you can give any number of names as well as how much you wish. So I shall give chapati, then after that I shall include fried rice. So I have included these names. So now in order to come out of this, you need to enter control space. So you need to use the control C in order to come out of this. So because, so once you use a cat command, the processes will be running at the back end. So here you are telling the cat command to create a file. So the processes, it will be running at the back end. So in order to come out of that, you need to use control C to come out of it. So now we have successfully, we shall check whether we have successfully created a file. So in order to view the contents of a file, it is possible with the help of cat command, which we have discussed in the previous videos. So cat followed by the name of the file, it's a food1.txt. So this will help us to view the contents of a file. So you can observe that so easily we have created a file with a single command, that is cat followed by this unidirectional symbol followed by the name of the file. So we have created these many names of the food. So with the help of cat followed by the name of the file, we are displaying the contents of the file, that is food1.txt. So now quickly we shall see the usage of a sort command, how we can sort it with the help of a sort command. So now we have successfully entered the contents into the file. So now with the help of a sort command, we shall directly sort the contents of the file. So that is for sort followed by the name of the file, that is food1.txt. So this will sort based on, so you can see that since we have given a character, so it will sort alphabetically. So you can see the first C comes in case of alphabet, so chapati is printed, then after that D, E, F, so F, G, I, N, P. Suppose if there exist the names that exist with the same letter, so first it checks for the first letter, then it moves to the second letter. So similarly it checks for all and prints it in alphabetical order. So next thing is that so here we have considered only the lowercase letters. Suppose if we have suppose if the input file contains the names of the food with fully uppercase letter or fully lowercase letter, so we shall see it how to sort it. So whether it sorts based on, so we shall see whether it sorts the lowercase letters first or uppercase letters first. So in order to that, so we shall create one more file, that is mixed. So that is the mixed.txt. So mixed.txt means you are going to include the uppercase letters as well as lowercase letters. So now I shall include apple. So we have considered all the lowercase letters. So now I shall include the uppercase letters. So I shall include banana. Next I shall include mango. Next I shall include orange. So next I shall include the grapes. So I have considered one fruit to be in lowercase letters and one to be uppercase letters, and we shall see how it sorts, whether the lowercase letters are sorted first or uppercase letters are sorted first. So similarly I shall include one more, that is a strawberry. So now in order to come out of it, Control C you need to press. So now we shall view the file with the help of a cat command, that is cat mixed.txt. So you can see here we have successfully created the file, that is mixed.txt, which includes both lowercase letters as well as uppercase letters. So now with the help of a sort command, we can see whether the lowercase letters are sorted first or uppercase letters are sorted. So when we have a mixed file, both uppercase and lowercase, the first lowercase letters are sorted, then the uppercase letters are sorted. So we shall check whether it is true or not. So with the help of a sort followed by the name of the file, that is a mixed.txt, press enter. So you can see first the lowercase letter is sorted, that is apple. Then next comes the banana. So in case of, so even it is printed alphabetically. So you can see first A comes, so the A is, apple is in lowercase letter, so first apple is printed. So there are no any fruits starting with letter A. So therefore it goes to the B. So at the B there are no any lowercase letters starting from B. So then after that it checks for uppercase letter. So there is a banana starting with B. So banana is printed. Similarly it goes to, again alphabetically it keeps on going. So next G, so grapes. Then after that we have a M, that is a mango. Then orange. Finally S comes, so it's a strawberry. So the uppercase letter, it's in uppercase letter, so therefore it is printed at the last. So it checks in alphabetical order, that is A, B, C, D, E, F. So this is how we can print with the, we can use the sort command in order to display the input file which includes the lowercase letters as well as uppercase letters. So this is the basic usage of sort command. So now we shall move to the sort options. So we can also use the sort command with the help of various options. So the first option we are going to use is the -o option. So first thing is that if the main usage of hyphen O option is that if you want to write the output to a new file, that is, it can be a output.txt file. So this can be done with the help of a hyphen O option. That is, instead of creating a file, you can directly write the contents to the output.txt file and you can view the contents. So this is done with the help of hyphen O option. So we shall see with the help of a sort command how easily we can view the output.txt file. So use the sort command followed by the file. So we are going to consider the file that is, so we shall consider the earlier file that is a food1.txt. So food1.txt file I am going to consider. Then after that I am going to use it. So I am going to redirect it to the output.txt file. So I am going to redirect it to the output.txt file. Then press enter. So next we shall see the usage of hyphen O option. So with the help of a sort command followed by hyphen O, then you are going to write the output.txt file. So output.txt followed by the input file, it is food1.txt. So food1.txt. So we have successfully, so here we are going to sort food1.txt. So food1.txt file is sorted and then you are going to append it. So you are going to redirect it to the output.txt file. So with the help of a hyphen O option, you are going to directly write the contents of food1.txt to the output.txt file. And with the help of a cat command, we can directly view the output.txt file. So output.txt file. So you can see that we have not entered any information in output.txt file. We are, with the help of hyphen O option, we are redirecting it to the output.txt file. So the contents of food1.txt file, we are redirecting it to the output.txt file. So this is done with the help of hyphen O option. So whatever the contents was there in food1.txt file, it is being redirected to the output.txt file. So that too in the sorted manner. So next thing is that, so we shall see the usage of hyphen R option. So hyphen R option, it is mainly used to sort it in a reverse order. So this command, it helps us to sort the input file in the reverse order, that is hyphen R option. So we shall see the usage of hyphen R option, that is sort hyphen R followed by the name of the file. So here we shall sort the mixer.txt file in a reverse order. Or you can also sort the food1.txt. I shall show you how to sort the food1.txt file. So you can see we are sorting the food1.txt file. So this is what actually the food1.txt file. So the file is same, that is the food1.txt file as well as the, we are redirecting it to output.txt file. So the content is same. So now with the help of hyphen R option, we are reversing the contents of the file. So you can see, so Pani Puri was at the end and we can observe it at the top. Similarly, noodles, idli. So we are printing it in reverse order. And you can also use this in order to sort the numbers. So just with the help of, so we shall see the how to sort the numbers also in reverse order, or how to sort it. Well, so then, so this is the hyphen R option. So which helps us to reverse the, which helps us to display the, print it in reverse order. So next option is that hyphen N option. So hyphen N option means, so this command, it is used to sort numerically as an A. So you are going to use the first letter. So R means you are going to reverse it. Similarly, hyphen N means you are going to sort it numerically. So first we shall create a file which contains the numbers. So with the help of a cat unidirectional symbol followed by the name of the file, I shall give it as num0.txt file. So we are creating a num0.txt file and now directly we shall enter the numbers into the file. So I shall write 50, 40, then 80, 90, then 55, then 70, then 60. So then after that, in order to come out of it, Control C. So now with the help of a cat command, we shall view the num0.txt file. So num0.txt file. So you can see that we have successfully able to create the num0.txt file and we have also viewed the content of num0.txt file. And now we shall see the usage of hyphen N option with the help of a sort command. So sort followed by hyphen N followed by name of the file, that is num0.txt. So this will sort numerically, or this will sort the numbers. So in numerically you are going to sort it. So you can observe that first 40 comes, then 50, 55, 60, 70, 80, 90. So this is how we are going to sort the numbers numerically. So with the help of hyphen and option. And you can also sort it in reverse order. So next option we are going to see is that how to sort the numbers in reverse order. So for numbers, to sort the numbers, you are going to use the hyphen N. And in order to sort it in reverse order, you are going to use NR. So hyphen NR is the option that is used to sort it in reverse order. So hyphen NR option, it sorts this numerical data in reverse order. So we shall check for this itself. So sort hyphen NR followed by the name of the file, that is num0.txt. So enter. So you can see that we have successfully sorted it in reverse order. So at the last we had 90 followed by 80, 70, 60. So we have sorted it in reverse order. So this is the usage of hyphen NR option. So next thing is that we shall use the next option is hyphen C option. So the first letter C means you are going to, so this option it is used to check whether the file is already sorted or not. So now we shall check for the food1.txt file whether the file is sorted or not. So with the help of a sort hyphen C followed by the name of the file, it's a food1.txt file, you are going to check it. So you can see food1.txt at line 4, it's a disorder GUI. So which means that, so we have successfully sorted the file, that is food1.txt file. So it is checking, so it's telling that we have successfully. So disorder means because initially we have sorted the file, and suppose you are going to check whether it is sorted or not. So it says that it's sorted. So it says that we have sorted the file. So next one, next option is that hyphen U option. So the hyphen U option and the sort, so with the help of a sort command, you are going to use the hyphen U option in order to remove the duplicates. So first we shall create a file so that exists duplicates. So cat followed by the name of the file, I shall give it as employee. I shall give the name of the file as we shall include the name. So we shall include the name 0.txt file. So we shall enter some random names. We shall enter some random names you wish, and then after that we are going to see we shall write duplicate names also in this, so that whether it will, with the help of a sort command, whether we can remove the duplicates or not, we shall check it. So we have successfully entered the data. Now with the help of a control C we are coming out of it, and then with the help of a cat command we shall view the contents of the file. So you can see that we can view the contents of the file. So here you can see that the name Akshita, it has been written two times. So now we shall check whether it will, with the help of a sort command, whether we can remove the duplicates or not. So sort followed by hyphen U option removes the duplicates that is present in a file. So hyphen U followed by the name of the file, it is name 0.txt file. So enter. So you can see that we have successfully removed the duplicates from the file. So there was Akshita two times written. So we have removed the duplicates successfully. So the next thing is that as we discussed earlier, that sort command, it also helps us to sort the months. So before that we shall create a month file, that is months.txt file, and we shall write the random months. So I shall write December. Then after that I shall write September, January, then May, then after that April, then after that March, then October. So control C to come out of it, and now with the help of a cat command we shall view the contents of months.txt file. So we are successfully able to view the contents of months.txt file. So with the help of hyphen capital M we can sort the months based on the months that appears. So we shall sort it with the help of a sort followed by the option hyphen capital M followed by the name of the file, it is months.txt. So we have successfully sorted it based on the months that appear. So initially January comes, then March, April, May, then September, October and December. So this is how we are going to use the sort command. So first we have seen with the help of a cat command how directly we can create a file, and then with the help of a sort command we have seen how to sort the food.txt file. Then after that we have seen how to sort the file which includes both lowercase letters as well as uppercase letters. So if it contains both lowercase and uppercase letters separately, then you are going to first it sorts the lowercase letter, then it sorts the uppercase letters. And next we have seen how to use the sort options. So the first option which we have seen is a hyphen option, which directly, so you are going to redirect the contents of the input file to the output file with the help of hyphen O option. Next we have seen the hyphen R option, and this is used to sort it in reverse order. Then after that we have also seen the hyphen N option. So this sort command, it will sort numerically. And next thing is the hyphen NR option, it will sort the numerical data in reverse order. And then hyphen C option, it checks whether the file is already sorted or not. So next thing is hyphen U option, this sort command. So with the help of a sort command followed by hyphen U option, you can remove the duplicates that is present in the input file. And next thing is that we have also seen how to sort the months that appears per year. So with the help of a hyphen followed by capital M, we are successfully sorted the months. So this is how you are going to use the usage of sort command in detail. So we have seen how to use the sort command along with the options. Thank you friends for watching, and do subscribe our channel for more updates.